Hello and welcome to the Lien Discovery video series, where we're going to be tackling head-on the issues faced by litigants around the country and around the globe as regards the coronavirus crisis. It's affected court deadlines everywhere, and litigation budgets have been impacted by the economic downturn. My name is Clinton Sanko. I'm the eDiscovery officer and a shareholder at Baker Donaldson, and I have with me today as a guest, Dave Dobson from Epiq Global. Welcome, Dave.
Good afternoon, Clinton. Great to be with you. Thanks for inviting me. Your firm has been an incredible partner for Epiq over many years, and it's a real delight to be with you today.
Dave, in preparing for today, I looked around the internet for Dave Dobson quotes, and I came across one that I thought was particularly appropriate as we kind of jump into the COVID crisis. And in this quote, you were more talking about, and I've seen this for years, the demands that are placed on IT departments. IT department, the budgets, they tend to shrink year over year, but their importance to the organization, the requirements of the business, and the desire of the business people for IT to be this kind of deeply embedded, integrated part of the business, it grows every year. And so there's that dichotomy. And you said, and I quote, "Everyone is scrambling to do more with less, to become more agile, and to find more cost-effective ways to support the business. The result is a transformative moment that offers, on the one hand, a tremendous opportunity for competitive differentiation, as well as, on the other hand, a huge strategic challenge." And I looked at that quote and I went, that's exactly where we are right now in May of 2020. The interesting thing is, and you may recall that you actually said that 10 years ago in 2011 when you were with CA Technologies. As you, if you were in the room right now and just kind of take a swath of your clients and their legal departments, you know, specifically to the in-house counsel, and you were sitting in a room with them and you were saying, here's one way to deal with that, or here's the best ways that we're seeing to deal with that, what would you tell them? I mean, and I guess the way I would frame this personally would be, how would you tell them how to get more value and to eliminate waste to get more out of their litigation spend?
Well, look, that I you must have done your research, because you're going back 10 years to find that quote, you'll find it inconsistent. We're all living in a very difficult environment, and you can never underestimate the human tragedy that we're all living through. But with that said, whether it's a financial recession like we saw back in 2008, 2009, and that's when I made that statement, the reason I told you there was reasons why I selected to be the CEO of this company back a year or so ago. And the second reason was exactly this point. We think, and I thought this a year and a half ago, that the legal industry is probably one of the last industries that is truly on the verge of a technological revolution, where the way legal work gets conducted, the way work gets done, how technology really helps accelerate and transform the practice of law, I think is in front of us. And I think we're gonna see probably over the next 5 years, some of the most exciting times that this industry has ever seen. And for some, it's gonna be a bit daunting. So that was one of the primary reasons why I joined the company. My entire background's in technology, and I have seen and been the part of, on both sides of the fences, by the way, where I'm the provider of technology to the marketplace, or I'm part of a company that leverages technology to deliver world-class solutions. So really to that point, as I talk to my new clients in this company, whether it's a law firm or a corporate general counsel law department, this is an incredible opportunity. As you look at, you know, where you spend your money and how work gets done, it's in these moments that you look to transform yourself. And to me, and I know I'm biased on this, but leveraging technology and world-class technology solutions, I think to me comes to the forefront of how you do that. And that's really how strategically we've oriented our company, is how do we make sure, and we've got deep support from our board of directors and our owners, on how do we invest substantially in technologies that will help reduce the cost of doing what we do. A great example is the document review process. I bet if we went back even 3 years ago, a typical document review might cost our clients $1 million. I'm just using that as a number. Today, using machine learning or technology, we could probably call that down to 20% or less. And I know we would have had people on my team saying, well, why do we want to do that? Won't that be bad for revenue? And our argument is, I use the expression, water will find its own level. If somebody can do it, I want to be the one that's part of that team that's finding that most efficient solution. So that's how we're driving our company going forward. So, you know, when we look at what companies should do, when I'm, you know, making a call on a general counsel, I'm really talking about how do you put in processes that are highly measurable, where you've got metrics that you can measure that are based on outcomes. And we typically look at three fundamental principles in everything we try to do with our clients. We develop these world-class playbooks that focus on process governance, that focus on risk mitigation, and finally, best-in-class cost management. And we think if our clients do that and we help them do that, we develop these enduring value relationships. So that's what we're focused on.